Today I'm joined by Simon Atkinson, the CTO of Presteigne Broadcast. Simon, thanks for joining us today. If you could just quickly, for those that may not be aware of Presteigne, just give us a quick overview of who Presteigne are, what you guys do, and your role at the company.
Yes, well, Presteigne is primarily a hire and projects company in the broadcast industry. As a business, we've been around for 30 years approximately, but in our current incarnation for about 6 or 7 years when a management buyout happened. So we specialise in renting out broadcast equipment to OBs and studios, both in the UK, Europe and further afield. Another part of our business is projects, so we can supply a turnkey solution with people and kit for any projects, small or large.
Tell us a bit about your role within the company.
My role is twofold. I'm CTO, for starters. So I oversee everything technical within the business with alongside Adrian Young, who's our CEO. So I give him support from the engineering and technical side of the business. And then I also look after the project side because that was my background as an engineer. Many years, too many to count. And so I look after the project side of the business as well. So I have sort of two hats to wear.
Excellent. If you could just talk through some of the Ross kit you have in stock, some of your more high profile customers that those listening might be aware of, and some of the events you've used those on.
Yeah, well, when I joined the company, we originally had a Ross Security Vision Mixer and an Ultrix video router. That was here when I first joined the company, and we've used it on many projects over the years since I've been for customers such as AP Media and the BBC. Last year, we sort of started ramping up our Ross purchases. So for the Euros for ITV Sport last year, we purchased two routers, a 5RU and a 2RU router, to do their MCR IBC systems in Amsterdam. So that was quite a big upscaling of our Ross equipment. And then since then, we have just recently bought a Carbonite Ultra Vision Mixer and a smaller router, 1RU router, to build a 12G PPU system. That's just been doing something for Google last weekend in Prague.
And so, Simon, also, if you could just talk about your experience working with Ross, where you see some of the benefits of working with our solutions.
The thing with the way we work is things get shipped everywhere. So it's I was very keen to find solutions that didn't involve many units of equipment to achieve one thing. So the beauty of your Ultrix routers is the fact that they can embed, de-embed, as well as video switch, all in the case of the 1RU, 1RU, you know, and it just saves an awful lot of shipping, where weight and shipping is expensive these days. And so anything we can do in a one box solution is really interesting to me and to the business. And it's a flexibility, the fact that being a virtual router, you can virtually do anything within that router once it's in there. You assign different sources to different audio, etc. Synchronization, multi-view is built in. It just makes it a very efficient workflow.
Looking to the future, you're obviously aware of some of the stuff we've got coming up and recent releases. Is there anything you'd be looking to add?
Yes, well, you know, going back to the discussion about everything in one box, what excites me a lot are your new software definable blades. I can see a great use for that in our larger routers to be able to put everything in one unit. Instead of, especially with the Acuity, which is quite a large unit to start with, if I can get a couple of Acuity blades into the 5RU router, for example, I get a very powerful flypack system in 5RU. And so, from a project's point of view, that is a really interesting solution to be able to put these projects together without having lots and lots of racks of equipment.
Brilliant. Thanks very much, Simon.
You're welcome.